So, good morning everyone.
Good morning.
So today we are going to discuss the most important and relevant topic, that is the National Education Policy 2020. Actually, there is a need of education policy to revamp the education system in our nation. And hence, on July 29, 2020, Union Cabinet approved a policy headed by K. Kasturi Rangan, the chief of ISRO. He proposed a draft of 484 pages consisting of various recommendations which can be seen in this policy. So, as we know, that the first education policy introduced in 1968 on the recommendation of Kothari Commission. Kothari Commission actually he supposed to have an equal education for all. After 1968, again the second education policy introduced in the time of Rajiv Gandhi, 84. In 1984, the education policy was basically based on the Operation Blackboard, which consists the education, quality education for all. After that, having few corrections, a new policy was come into existence in 1992 in the time of P.P. Narasimha Rao and Manmohan Singh, which basically gave the idea of entrance examination such as IEEE, AIEEE, such kind of interesting examination were introduced in the third education policy of 1992. And the last one, the NEP, National Education Policy 2020, has been introduced by the Union Cabinet Ministry on 29 July 2020. Actually, the new policy replaces the previous national policy on education 1986. The main theme of this education policy is to globalize the education, means we have to be equivalent in education, whatever it is going on world level. So the globalization of education is the main theme of this education policy, because our generation has been changed, the demand has been changed, so there is a need of new education policy which can lead our youth energy into a big transformation. So now I request you sir for next slide. Little bit you want to focus on this diagram. So as we can see that this NEP was emphasized by ISRO CFK Kasturi Rangan. The draft new education policy 2019 was later released by Ministry of Human Resource Development. It is also available in our portal of Education Ministry. Right now, the big change is that the MHRD was now called Education Ministry. So now this draft is available on the website of Education Ministry. You can also visit. Now, sir, I will give you a message. Reason. What is the reason of this education policy? There are two reasons for this policy. Number one, to globalize the education system. And number two is that the quality education. Whatever the education is there, quality must be there. Even educated person can take a wrong decision, can be vulgar for society and cannot be suitable for society. So basically we need to provide a quality education. So the reason is that to modernize the education and to give quality education with the proper skills and scope. I request you, sir, for next year. The principles of this policy are very simple. Recognizing, identifying, and fostering the unique capabilities of each student by sensitizing teachers as well as parents to promote each student's holistic development in both academic and non-academic disciplines. Each one has a special kind of discipline or knowledge, and we have to set this knowledge in a proper way. So basically, we have to focus each student. If a student is not good in study, he may be good in either games or other activity. So we need to provide a proper way, proper channel to make a proper development in a good way. So recognize the students in need, identify them, and develop the properties to enhance their skill. According to the highest priority to achieving foundational literacy and numeracy by all students by grade 3, it is surprising to know that to apply that early education policy, we are going to invest 6% of our GDP. It's a huge amount. So if we are going to invest this huge amount in this policy, so the main thing must be there, no one should be illiterate. At least each and everyone must have the ability of numeracy and literacy. Number 3, flexibility. Flexibility means there is a multiple entry and exit. Multiple exit and entry means we can leave our academic session in between, or we can join in between anytime. So if you are pursuing graduation and you complete 1 year of your degree and you leave that session, so don't worry, that year will not collapse. If you again join this degree courses after 2 years, then the previous one could be added. So there is no collapse of academic session. There is a provision of multiple exit and multiple entry. This is the flexibility of this national education policy. Now, let's see. No hard separation between arts, science, between curricular and extracurricular activities, between vocational and academic streams, etc. Most important, no separation means 2021 onwards, if a state applies this policy, then there should not be any stream called arts, science, commerce. According to this policy, a student may have the subjects such as maths, history, accounts, political science, whatever they want. Means there is no borderline which classifies the students as arts, commerce, and science. No separation at all. And now this is the borderline. Next, the multidisciplinary and the holistic education across the science, social sciences, arts, humanities, and sports for multidisciplinary world in order to ensure the unity and integrity of all minds. Nowadays, games is not the part of your curricular activity. It is the core curricular activity. But in this policy, games would be involved in the part of curricular activities, because if a student wants to grow himself only co-curricular subject at all. Emphasis on conceptual understanding rather than rote learning and learning through exams. Actually, this policy also makes less students by bothering too much pressure. So there is emphasis on understanding, not on for what learning and learning for exams. So we are not going to students to make informative. Informative is what? Information is also available on Google site. But the main thing is that we need to make each and every one to understand the concepts in a proper way. So this is the main thing of this education policy. One of the things here that to eliminate harmful hierarchies of anxieties between different areas of learning. That means there would not be any special kinds of area where a particular student can go. Each and every student, he can proceed. I request you, sir, for the next slide. The next one. Creativity and critical thinking to encourage logical decision making and innovation. The main purpose of our education system is that we can take the right decision at the right time. If you are able to take the right decision in a proper way, that means you are a good skilled person, you are educated one. And we are educated and not taking the proper decision in our life, it is not good. So the main thing is that we need to develop creativity and critical thinking to encourage logical decision making. Decision making must be there for a well educated person, and we are going to make it. Ethics and human constitutional values like empathy. The today's news is that in Mumbai, one girl's gone with culture. So what is the value of society? Means we are creating such a guy which are going to do such vulgar activities. So how it is there? This is only the kind of our thought process. Means the thought process of that boy such that he can do such vulgar crimes. So why it is so happening in our society? We are responsible for that. So we need to ethics with our education system. Ethics is very important. Human and constitutional values like empathy, respect for others, cleanliness, courtesy, democratic spirit of service. This kind of things must indulge there. So ethics, spirit, and patriotism, it must be there. Next one, promoting a multilingualism and the power of languages in teaching and learning. In the commission of 1984, there was a provision of three languages. One is the English, second Hindi, and one from any kind of language which is the identification of a local area or state. But here, multilingualism means each and every school can set up a system where the language of foreign one will also be provided. Suppose our school also open the system of German languages, French languages. This kind of things can be done here. Students can opt multilingualism. But right now, it's a provision that students can take at least three languages at a time, like in our area, Hindi, Sanskrit, and English. Focus on Light skills such as communication, cooperation, humor, and resilience focus on regular cognitive assessment for learning later than the summative assessment that encourages today's working culture. Very important point. Not focus on summative assessment, focus on the formative assessment. Take a short test, particularly interview. It would make a good sense of holistic development in a student. So, a formative assessment must be there. And also, a provision is made that in this national education policy, the board examination of class 10 and class 12 is going to eliminate. Rather than CBSE would focus on semester examination from 9 to standard 12. Extensive use of technology in teaching and learning. In this policy, there is a provision to have the skills of technology and software so that we can explain or elaborate many kinds of things to make students more informative. Respect for diversity and respect for the local context in all curriculum, technology and policy, always keeping in mind that education is a continuing subject. Education means we are focusing the local content and the local context of curriculum, languages and all things. So it's important to elaborate here that a respect for the local context. If you are from Jharkhand state, you must have a good knowledge of Jharkhand culture. And you are having too much to hide about English and Jharkhand, you don't know about Jharkhand languages and its culture. So it's not a good thing. You must have the knowledge of the specific one. This is the provision in this national education policy. That in curriculum across all levels of education from early childhood care and education to school education to higher education. A committee or a commission which has been set up to take after all the things for the development of students. Such system is called National Systems of Care for Childhood Development. Teachers and faculty at the heart of the learning process, the requirement, continuous professional development, positive work environment, and service conditions. Teachers are the core of the system, so CBSE organize many programs regarding this, and they are also doing training such kind of 25 hours of in-house and online training. This is also the part of national education policy. The main aim is that to train all the teachers to make prepare for upcoming generation by 2030. It is the goal that by 2030 there should be a drastic changes in our education system. So we are going to the first kind of now, as we think that this policy consists of many recommendations starting from school level to university, so first of all we think or focus on school education. This is the previous one and this is the new one. In the previous one, there were no system before the ages of 6. After all, we know that our education system system was based on 10 plus 2 system. So before the, you can see here, covering ages 6 to 16, means in previous one, there is no provisions of classes like nursery, KG 1, KG 2 in the previous one. But in the new one, we can see all things can be separated into 5 plus 3 plus 3 plus 4 system. Means first of all, a student would spend 5 years as an early childhood having ages 3 to 8. Huh? So covering ages 3 to 8 means having 5 classes, nursery, KG 1, KG 2, class 1 and class 2. This is the 5 years. So first of all, students would cover 5 classes and then plus 3. Plus 3 means classes 3, 4, 5. Again plus 3 means 6, 7, 8. And then plus 4, 9, 10, 11 and 12. This is the 5 plus 3 plus 3 plus 4 system covering ages 3 to 18 and some intervention techniques. So this is the big changes because we are going to develop good skills of language learning. We are going to set up the foundation courses in this level called foundation level, then primary and that middle one and the second one. Higher education, but I also want to say more things here about school education. In this policy, there is a provision to curtail the weight of the student's bag. In this policy, only 10% of total weight of one student is allowed to have. More than 10% weight of itself is not allowed. Again, in the foundation level, we would develop a fundamental knowledge about their languages, numeracy, and literacy. In the primary one level, that means classes 3 to 5, we would develop the approaching way how to have the such as addition, subtraction, multiplication, such kind of things we have to develop in the ages between 8 to 11 for class 3 to 5. Many more things are there. You can also visit this draft policy available on the MHRD ministry. Now we would focus on higher education. For the purpose of developing holistic individuals, it is essential that an identified set of skills and values will be incorporated at each stage of learning from pre-school to higher education. The main thing is here that for developing holistic individuals, we are good only in study. It's not the end of our education system. We need to develop in a multiple way, that means a student must have a good sense in education, sports, art, music, and many auxiliary. So, it's a purpose to develop a holistic development in a student. Second one, at the social level, higher education must enable the development of an enlightened, socially conscious, knowledge and skill nation that can find and implement robust solutions to its own problems. The main problem for our country is that population. So make a system that our energy of population must be transformed into a proper way such that it can be used in the development of our nation. So make students skilled. Skilled means the one must have knowledge of computer, games, art, craft, music, carpenters, and whatever else. Okay. So the skills must be there so that the students may contribute their skills to the development of our nation. Higher education must form the basis for knowledge creation and innovation, thereby contributing to a growing national economy. In India, it's very easy to have a higher education, but the term is here, innovation, thereby. If you are not going to innovate some kind of thing, then what's the use of your knowledge in our society? So the purpose of higher education must be their innovation. Either you come from the arts, commerce and science, some new things, some critical thinking must be there that should be helpful for our society. So this is the important one. Now, the purpose of quality education is therefore more than the creation of greater opportunities for individual employment. What I have told you that to instill quality education so that one can be helpful to growth of our education system and our nation. In this things we need to know what kind of organization are being set up to foster this policy. So first of all, ATEI, that means ATEI stands for Higher Education Institute. It's not mentioned here. So this is the organization which covers all the universities and it provides guidance for proper and holistic education to all students. Which aim to have over 3,000 or more students in our individual university. A state-wise mechanism for granting graded autonomy to colleges through a transparent system of graded accreditation is established. Colleges will be encouraged to mentor. Now colleges are being graded by NET. So in this system, NET provides a grade where the optimum facility and knowledge can be provided to students. If students opt for a more quality education and infrastructure, so he must take the next grade for particular colleges and university, so that we can be confirmed which kinds of things are being provided here and what is the quality education of university. Now I request you to go to the next slide. Optimal learning. Optimal learning, what is it? Effective learning requires a comprehensive approach that involves appropriate curriculum. The curriculum must be interesting and relevant. Now what is the effective learning? Effective learning and comprehensive approach. Comprehensive approach is what you get education from classes between people get the higher education. So you have to gather all the information together and just analyze. What are the things that is useful opinion that the ministry in the next book of NCRT, keeping the fact the mind that some chapters are not relevant in the modern society. So that chapter is not going to be have in our next session. This is the position here. In order to promote creativity, institution and faculty will have the autonomy to invite on matters of curriculum, pedagogy and assessment within a broad framework of higher education qualification that ensures consistency across institutions and programs across the ODL. Anyone can say what is ODL? Open distance learning. A traditional class mode. So ODL and regular classes work of focus on the holistic development of the students. So there should not be any boundary that students cannot have a proper education, because we can see some students cannot proceed in the education. The drop out rates are very high here, about 10 to 14% for secondary examination. So this kind of things are here. So we need to outline the system, framework a system where students do not have tendency to drop out. We have to make it catch in our system to develop such kinds of things. Now, also to the next one. This is the main aims of our university localization. We need to stand our education system in the rank of world level policy, education policy. So world level education policy can be systemized with our education policy, so that we can also say whatever the education is being given in America, such kind of education is also provided in our India. So globalization is very important in this thing. The various initiatives mentioned above will also help in having larger numbers of international students studying in India and provide greater mobility to students in India who may wish to visit, study and transfer their needs to our area of research at institutional level and vice versa. In this point, important topic is here. The provision for credit bank means whatever the records we have got in our education system from nursery to class 12 or higher one, all the marks or record will be kept in a system such as called a credit bank. You can fetch, you have all the credits, your marks for further study. Means your academic will not collapse, your marks will not collapse. All such kind of things would be set up in a system called a credit bank. And for our better education for international students, a committee is being set up in our system. The aim for that committee is to provide the channel between our education systems and the international education system. The main motto of that committee is to provide all such kinds of things which can promote the student to have study in India. Number two, Indian languages, Arjun system of medicine, yoga, arts, music, history, culture, and modern India internationally relevant curriculum, science, social science, and beyond, meaningful opportunity for social engagement, and quality residential facilities and on campus support, etc. This is the internet. national levels of education system means the education system or its institution must have a proper infrastructure to provide residential facilities, quality education and on-campus support. So these kind of things are there. Now I request you for the next slide. Teacher education. Right now we opt for two kind of examination. One is for class 5 to 8 and the second is 1 to 5 and 6 to 8. But now it will be into 4 parts. For the 3 to 2, 3 to 5 and 6 to 8 and 1 is another 8 to
1.
So 4 parts will be there. Right now only 2 cases are there and the 4-year integrated period offered by such multidisciplinary higher education institution will be by 2030. So by 2030 the BM program will be of 4 years, but it would consist of 3 years of our degree program and 1 year of our BS program. So total it is of 4 years. Means in 4 years you would have dual degree, one for your degree and one for your BM. So teacher education is vital in creating a pool of school teachers that will shape the next generation. It is a big challenge to apply this policy in all our community. It is a matter of scale we will apply this policy in respective one. Right now Maharashtra and Tamil Nadu, Odisha, such kind of states are there which have applied this policy. But right now a major part are left where this policy is not applied. So a system required to make it confirm that this policy should be there. So its effective governance policy that enables the creation of culture of excellence and innovation in a higher education institution. India has indeed been the existence of strong self-governance and outstanding merit-based appointments of institutional leaders means for fostering this policy, we can set up the multiple appointment of institutional leaders in our state level which would govern the application of this policy. Now, technology use and integration. Well, this policy also consists of tremendous use of technology and its integration. It's a demand of our generation. We should have such kind of things that means we can make the digital India with the help of a special kind of teaching tool, special kind of software, whiteboard and multiple things are there which come up in the era. So this education policy has special provision to use such kind of things by which we can develop a better understanding and skill to our education system. Thank you. decision that very bodies are there, MHRD, CAPE, NCRT, SCRT, HCI, NTA, all are responsible to ensure the application of such kinds of policy. So it's the okay, it's very informative session.